Sometimes it's hard for me to understand, but you're teaching me to be a better man. I don't wanna take this life for granted like I used to do. No, no, I wanna love somebody like you. I'm ready to
where do we go now? Right, I remember one time Rick was about 8 years old, came over to my place, which I lived next door to Robin Jeff, of course, and he was helping me with the old HRU. We were fixing up the tailgate, and he put him in the back, and I said, Rick, now don't go mucking around, we've got to clean this rear up. So he started mucking around, I turned around, and there he is, grabbed on the back of the ute tailgate, down he come, tailgate fell off, he fell off, on his head, went home crying. I thought I was going to get in trouble with Mum and Dad, but anyway, I didn't. Hey, Rick, do you remember that one? All the best, bud. Good.
So, one of my outstanding memories with Rick was the one time I decided to not buy a Ford. We went and picked up a VK Brock Commodore, and I needed Rick to come to drive it back because I was too nervous, and we got to about Brooks Road on the Hume Highway, and Rick says, I don't mean to alarm you, mate, but look in the rear vision mirror. So I've looked out the back, and there is blue smoke pouring out the back of it. This rotten car, the motor, was no good. And so, yeah, we had to drive, turn around, take it all the way back to the dealer to get this stupid Commodore fixed. So don't buy a Holden. But we did spend time. He was the only one game enough to drill holes in the bonnet to mount a bonnet scoop for me. Yeah, a lot of good time spent around cars. It's been really good.
Rick, how are you? I guess one of the moments that sticks out clearly for me was the time in which you visited Turner Road when you had your car detailed. And obviously, very proud owners, very fastidious with the way we keep our vehicles. My brother Jason decides to let his dog into your vehicle. Yeah, muddy, and you weren't very happy at all. And you took matters into your own hands and decided to relieve yourself in my brother's office. So that's one of the moments that really stick out with, in the past, and it's something that obviously will stay with me, plus others. There are many others. But take care.
Hey, Rick, I was just thinking about the time, mate, when you decided to borrow Kevin Hogg's push bike. Because that worked out so well for you, didn't it? Especially when you went down the side driveway, and I think you might have gone into the shed with Dad's Silver XW at maybe 20, 30 mile an hour and hit the back of it. And from memory, I think you ended up on the bonnet. And then after that, I do remember Dad going down and pulling the roller door down. I don't know what happened in the shed. But there was a lot of banging, crashing and yelling. But, yeah. And I thought that would be something that we could sort of think about. That was pretty damn funny. And I thought the other one too, mate. I mentioned it the other day, but I think you might have forgotten. But we were working on a Falcon. I think I was doing a gearbox, and I asked you to pass a spanner, and then you refuse to, and I got out and I got a bit cranky, and I think we went the knuckle, to be honest. And all I remember after that was Dad getting his big steel cap boot, and I remember it hit me in the back of the head, and that was super exciting.
Remember the time when you took Dace to the hospital when the dog bit him? Man, that was a drive and a half. I remember being in the back, and I didn't think we were going to get anywhere. You were driving so fast, and it was just panic mode.
G'day, Rick. You know, we've known you since you were born, or before that, actually. But I do remember your unique driving style when we're off to the hospital. I don't know whether you can drive from the horizontal position, but apparently you can. So, you know, it was interesting, and interesting times. Good to see that you haven't changed. You're still happy-go-lucky, and we hope all goes well for you.
Yes, good luck, Rick. We love you. Rick. We love you to the moon and back, and we're here for you whenever you need it. Love you, Rick. Bye.
Bye.
Yeah. G'day, Rick. Wanted to share a couple of memories from when we were younger. Remember all the times when hanging out with our parents and all of that kind of thing. But particularly when your dog decided to have a crack at my arm, and you gave us the the race car treatment in the Cortina, sliding around the back to the hospital. That was an interesting drive.
Hey Ricky, glad to be a part of today. You're a good friend, and always got a smile on your face at work. Always up for a chat. Always willing to help out. You helped me out a few times with the hoist and stuff. It's been greatly appreciated, and always up for like driving the truck around the yard, and you know, stick my hand out the truck, and you toot the horn, you know, as if you got the big air horns. But it's a good day, and I'm glad the weather turned out today, and got all your friends and family around you. Can't think of too much else, mate. I've known you for a while. You're a good mate. All the best, and good luck with everything. And you know, fight hard, mate.
Hey, Rick. I remember. I don't know when it was. Must have just had my license, I'd say. So we're talking 30 odd years ago, and I just bought a Holden Rodeo crew cab ute, and we went down the back of Campbelltown there and four-wheel driving, and I remember we're going through some sort of concrete canal, and you were on the passenger side, and the vehicle was teetering on two wheels only, and I started getting a bit scared, and you were hanging out the window trying to rock the car to get me some traction, and saying, yeah, we'll make it, and man, that was a pretty scary time. And then the other time we were going through up in one of the national parks in the same ute, and we went through a water crossing, and I sucked in a gob full of water, and thing seized. So that was a brand new car, brand new four-wheel drive. So mate, it's some really good memories, and let alone watching Bad Boy Bubby. That was the highlight, mate. So anyway, take care.
Hi Rick, it's good to spend today with you. Lots of memories with you guys growing up, being the only girl of the group as well, so, but you've never made me feel left out. Always remember singing around the pianola and swimming and going on drives, and of course talks of cars, which a girl wasn't really interested in, but we're happy to have today with you, and very happy that your daughter was named after me. That was a great honour. So, cheers.